Good morning to all of you. Now, in this demonstration, I would like to demonstrate the use of certain specific tools which are useful to carry out analysis or design problems. One of the issues, especially when you try to simulate using any commercial process simulator like Aspen, is most of the models that are available in such commercial simulators can only perform rating calculations. So what are we going to do in case if we are required to perform design or even analysis problems? You already know what is the clear-cut difference between rating, design or analysis problems. Now to do this, I would like to demonstrate this particular example in this demonstration and specifically concentrate on two important tools that may be necessary to carry out design or analysis problems. Now this is a very simple unit, mixer. Two input streams are getting mixed with respect to, two input streams are getting mixed to give rise to one output stream. Now let us try to simulate this by going into Aspen. Now the two components involved in this problem are isobutane. And the other one is isobutene. This is the commercial name is 1-butene. Now I have declared both the components involved in the problem. Say next. Now you are required to choose a method. As I said, let me choose one of these methods. Anyway, as far as this problem is concerned, we are dealing with only mass balance. We are interested in mass balance. So the property method may not really make any difference. Say next. As we have seen, by default, you may be under properties. So I would like to go into simulation environment. So click on simulation environment, save OK. Now using the graphical user interface, create the problem, draw the problem. I have selected the mixer model. Then I am trying to connect the two input streams. And one output stream. I would also like to rename these streams as per the problem statement. Click on the stream and click the right mouse button so you can see this. So this is feed. The other input stream is given as recycle. And the output stream is given as product. So having drawn the problem using the graphical user interface, now you will be in a position to go to the next screen. So press N. Now as is the case, because the mixer model is written in rating mode, I am required to give both the input streams. Remember, no information is being sought with respect to the output stream. Even if you try to forcibly open and provide information, that will be ignored. Because any rating model will only take the input values with respect to input streams and depending on the type of model may require certain equipment parameters. Now I am specifying feed, so as I am interested only in mass balance, the temperature and pressure may not really matter. I choose some arbitrary values here, let us say 50 degrees centigrade, 1 bar. Now you know the total flow rate is 100 kilomoles per hour and the composition of fresh feed is in terms of, let us say, mole fraction pure isobutane, right? So we were able to declare how many variables, temperature, pressure, and total flow rate along with the composition. In fact, one is not exactly necessary. Instead of specifying the total flow rate here, if you specify the flow rate of isobutane as 100, that would be sufficient. So we were able to specify the feed. Now go to the next input screen. Now again, we are required to specify the recycle stream. Now again, let me assume some temperature and pressure, maybe same as what I have done for stream 1 or feed. Now I know the composition as 0.8 and 0.2. Right. This is what I have known. So let me go to the next input screen. Remember, still we are not able to address the input. You can see required input is not complete. How many variables we were able to define? temperature, pressure, and only one mole fraction. Remember, the other mole fraction is not independent. Let us see anyway by pressing next. Now you can see there is an error. The required information with respect to the recycle is not complete. Total flow must be specified when composition basis is mole fraction, mass fraction, or volume fraction. So I need to specify the total flow rate. But as you can see from this problem, I am required to calculate the recycle flow rate such that the product composition would be like this. Unfortunately, this problem can be handled quite easily if you try to do it manually by writing simple mass balances. But because we are trying to make use of a model written in rating mode, now I am required to specify the input streams, then only it will calculate the output stream. Whatever information that I know with respect to the output stream cannot be provided as input information to the problem. So there is no other way but to assume some flow. Let us assume the flow rate of even recycle as 100. Now you can see the required specification with respect to the recycle is complete. Now you can go on to the next input screen. You can run the simulation. Now you will be able to see the results, say stream summary. Now you can see you were not able to observe the mole fractions of either feed, product, or recycle. If you are interested in looking at even the mole fractions, what you can do is, by default it is not included in your stream report. So you will have to expand setup, go to report options, then click on stream, click on this mole. That means you are asking the report to include the mole fractions of every stream. Now with this, once again run the simulation to take this into account. Now once again, if you try to see the stream summary, now you are able to see the mole fractions of all streams. This is what has been given with respect to feed and recycle. Now obviously, the product has got a particular composition, 0.9 and 0.1. But what is that we require? 95% isobutane and 5% isobutene. So whatever flow rate that we have assumed with respect to the recycle is not giving me the required output. Now let me make one more iteration. Because we started with an initial approximation of 100, now let me, should it be increased or decreased? As you see, the flow rate of the recycle should be decreased from 100 in order to improve the mole fraction of isobutane in the output. Let me make some assumption, say another assumption as 50 instead of 100. Now let us once again run the simulation. Now you can once again see the results. Now the mole fraction in the of the product stream from 0.9 has gone up to 0.933. Still, we were not able to satisfy our requirement of obtaining 95% isobutane in the product stream. So are you going to do like this each time, assuming the recycle flow rate till you match with your requirement? This is typically an analysis problem, because whatever output that I am going to get from the problem is not accepted until and unless the mole fractions are within acceptable limit, the problem cannot be complete. So in order to do this, we have two different tools. Let me try to introduce one of those tools to start with. Now you can look at the left hand side control panel, click on model analysis tools, expand model analysis tools. There are number of such model analysis tools. Select the first one, sensitivity, say new. By default it gives a name as S1, okay. Now you can see there are three things that you need to address whenever you carry out this kind of a sensitivity study. Vary, define, tabulate. Define is what is meant by your target. It is something like a set point in your process control domain. Vary is nothing but the manipulated variable. By manipulating, you will be able to match, or you will be able to satisfy the requirement with respect to the set point. Now, what is the manipulated variable here? We are assuming the recycle flow rate and trying to get the required purity with respect to the product stream. So the vary variable in this particular case is going to be a stream variable. Now the stream is recycle. the variable is mole flow in kilomoles per hour. Be careful, especially when you try to use either sensitivity or design spec, you must be consistent with your units. Now let me say the lower limit is 10, upper limit is 50, let us say in increments of 1. So what I am trying to do is assume the recycle flow rate as 10, calculate the output purity, right, and then increment it by 1 till you go on doing this till you reach the upper limit of 50. So we were able to define what is meant by vary. Now let us say next. Now this is with respect to define. What is that you would like to get? Let us say new. I am interested in obtaining a particular product purity. You can give any name of your choice here. And this variable that you have named should be carefully defined. Again, it's a stream variable. Now the stream variable mole fraction. Stream is product. And component is one of the components you can choose, isobutane. Right? So once again, we were able to satisfy this define. Then go to next, tabulate. You can simply say fill variables. Next. Now, though you can see the stream summary, I would like you to see the results of your sensitivity. As I said, I am trying to assume the recycle flow rate as 10. And I am interested in calculating the product purity. Now, as I increment the recycle flow rate by 1, you are able to observe how the product purity is changing. But what is our requirement? We wanted to get something like 0.95. Now, you can see from this plot, from this result, the requirement of 0.95, the actual answer may be lying between 33 and 34. Remember, in the case of sensitivity, you will be able to identify how a particular variable is changing with respect to the manipulated variable. But there is no way the simulator can know that you are interested in a particular target variable. This is one of the issues, especially with respect to sensitivity. Now, if you are interested, you can also plot this behavior. Go to plot. Now, choose this as x-axis variable. Okay. Now you will be able to see this is the manipulated variable. Now if you are looking at 0.95, you can see the result is somewhere between 33 and 34. This is how you may be able to find the answer, but the simulator will not exactly know that you are interested in a particular product purity. Now I would like you to see another type of tool to do more or less the same kind of problem. This is probably one of the better tools even when compared to sensitivity. Now if you try to see, for example, I'm sorry, I should have shown you the stream results. Yeah. Still remember, because we said the stream recycle flow rate is 50, the results of your product will correspond to whatever assumption you have done. So whatever calculations you are doing with respect to sensitivity are outside this block. There is no way you can influence this result. If you want to make an influence on this result, you will have to change this value. Then only these results are updated. Anyway, now let us go into the next option. Expand this flow sheeting options. Again, there may be a number of options. We'll see a few of them as we progress. Now, I would like to use this design spec. Say new. By default, it gives a name DS1. Now, more or less the same things, define and vary are similar to whatever you have done in sensitivity, but there is an additional thing known as spec. Now, define is automatically the target. We wanted to maintain a particular product purity. Now, what kind of a variable is this? It's a stream variable. The variable is mole fraction, stream is product. Component is one of them, isobutane. So we were able to define, say, let us say next. Now, this is the additional thing that we are giving compared to your sensitivity. The spec with respect to product purity is, I wanted this to have a particular value, 0.95, some tolerance, a lower value, right? So this is the spec I am looking at. Now, unlike your sensitivity, you are telling the simulator that you are interested in a particular product purity. Say next. Now, what is the variable that you are trying to manipulate, same as what you have done in the case of sensitivity, that is again stream variable. Stream is recycle and the variable is flow rate, mole flow. Lower limit 10 to let us say 1000. Now you don't have to worry about specifying the other things. In fact, there is good amount of mathematics. A particular type of mathematical method is being employed to solve this kind of a problem. If possible, we'll try to discuss that in the theory class next week. Now I'm saying next. Close. Now you can see this block is being repeatedly calculated. How many times? 4 times. And by the 4th iteration, you were able to get to a convergent solution. And you can also see the method that has been employed here. Probably, as I said, I will try to highlight what kind of a mathematical method you can make use, what actual type of calculations are involved in one of the theory classes. Now let us look at these results. DS1 results. Now you can see this is the initial value that we started with. Now the final value is 33.397, and corresponding to this recycle flow rate, we were able to get a product purity of almost 0.95. This is within your error tolerance. Now you will be also able to see the stream summary. Now, unlike what happened in the case of sensitivity, now if your design spec is satisfied, though we started with an initial recycle flow rate of 50, now because you were able to come to a convergent solution, the actual answer has been the previous value has been rewritten by the actual answer. Similarly, you will be able to see the product compositions also are matching with your requirement. So in case, if you use some kind of a design spec, now if this product is going to another unit and if you are required to maintain that kind of a purity, these values are going to be made available even for further calculations. Whereas sensitivity, there is no such option. In case of sensitivity, you may have to obtain the answer outside the block, and if you are required to update those values, you may have to replace the recycle flow rate with the one that has been obtained from sensitivity. Whereas design spec automatically takes care of this kind of an information. Now you can also see, I don't know whether I can show you this. I'll try to show you the design spec also can be combined. I'll try to show you maybe in another exercise. For the time being, let me stop here.